here. So if you are in any way concerned about that, that's just kind of what we're doing is to document that. So my name is Cosima, and I'm a Beacon Hill resident, and I have lived in Beacon Hill since 2006. I come from Southern California, and I have a background in commercial real estate. I want to thank everybody for taking the time and effort to be here tonight. In June of 2010, I started reaching out to people to discuss the various projects happening around the city that affected Fredericksburg Road, like Via Primo service, Martinez Creek restoration, linear trail. So that started in mid-2010. It's hard to believe that that was 5 years ago already. And then in 2012, the property at the corner of Woodlawn and Fred was sold to a developer. The buildings were demolished, and at that time I knew it was time to kind of move from talking to doing and to get something more formalized going so that we would be prepared. So in late 2012, November, we had our committee meeting. Our host tonight is Max Woodward with two dogs. This is his space. He was my co-chair in the beginning. Thank you, Max, for allowing us to use his space.
Class,
big round of applause. Now, we're not just going to school on Saturday. share those. So anyway, so that's kind of what the idea was behind the Fredericksburg Road Committee. We're to a point now where we need to hear from you all, and we need to see what input we can take from you back to the city. So let me just make sure I got everybody. Thank David Vogel. David, where are you? He's an Alta Vista resident and architect. He brought an aerial map. He's done some help with the visioning as well. Saxton, Charlotte, Max, John Hainsworth sits on the committee. He owns a building, a couple buildings on the corridor. He's been very helpful, and so forth. Garcias, they provided the parking. People, the businesses need parking, the residents don't want their streets full of cars. We have to figure out the parking solution. So in the meantime, we appreciate Garcia's. Color Tone does a great job of sharing their parking at night with the Uptown Studios. That's how we get over these challenges, is by coming together and working together. And then I'm gonna do a quick PowerPoint. I'm gonna have, after that, I'm gonna have Charlotte Lucas and Lucas say something from NAPCAS, and then I'll give it over.
Did you okay the councilman's office and
yes.
Menendez's office is here?
Well, yes, I think I did point that out, but we do have. And the councilman's office printed flyers for us. They've been very supportive, so I appreciate that. And let's just all now hope that I don't have technical difficulties, because if there's a weakness in my presentation, it's this part.
Your
email's bad. Yeah, right. Okay, now how do we, oh no, that was the opposite thing I wanted to do. Anybody know how I make this go all the way big? And I'm going to run out of battery by early 12. So let me get my PowerPoint get plugged in. Right there. Okay, so just plug me in. Have an extra alphabet close by. Max, power. I'm gonna lose it here any second. Where can I reach to?
You got one plugged in, is that the next?
Or if there's something that I don't see plugged in. Okay, so. Trail. We talked about briefly. I'll have a little bit more info on this. Uptown, for those of you who remember the Uptown Theater, which is now St. Anne's. Piggly Wiggly on the corridor. We had a pig stand, the Beacon Hill Baptist Church that's been there since 1912, and then on the corner that's now vacant, you've got what used to be the Hobby Store and Lumber Yards. So this area used to actually be called Uptown. And one of the things that we kind of are interested in hearing is that something we want to go back to? Do we want to go back to kind of promoting our corridor as Uptown, or Uptown on Fredericksburg? Something to consider. So, I know, but he's worked, oh, I'm not plugged in?
No.
There you are.
You are. You had the battery.
Okay, is this, why is this the same?
Yes.
Oh, there it goes, okay. So Uptown included the construction of a noteworthy cluster of buildings in the 700 block of Fredericksburg Road from 1925 to 1931. It's one of the oldest thoroughfares in the city. It began as a wagon road in the 1840s. By the 1920s, it was a link to the old Spanish Trail, again, that Charles Hales organization. So part of the Transcontinental Highway that stretched across the southern United States from Florida to California. Fredericksburg Road was part of that auto trail. Automobile traffic and residential development north of the city in the 1920s led to a commercial boom along this corridor. old Spanish trail again. So here's the, on the left is an old picture of the Uptown Theater. And on the right, the way it looks today is St. Anne's Parish Center. Many of us on the committee think that this building should be designated historic. The Archdiocese owns it. It's some request that pretty much they would have to make. But if people were, if the general public were behind that, we'd consider doing that. The Piggly Wiggly's building, which is over there on French and Michigan, has already been designated a historic landmark. It currently has multi-tenants in it, some live work spaces. The pig stand down in the 300 Beckwalk, already a historic landmark, and recently became Big Louie's Cafe. And then the Beacon Hill Baptist Church, again, that was built in 1912. And the former lumber yard, which now this is all gone. So, and just as for knowledge purpose, the demolition of a building is not a public process, unlike zoning or planning. The owner goes to the city, says, I want to demolish my building. Office of Historic Preservation reviews it. If they agree, then the building gets to be demolished. It's not a public process. So where are we today? So there are a number of things that pop up along the corridor. Possible brownfields where there's been land contamination, those can be tricky. But the city has a program to help with that. So we need to make sure that the property owners are aware. Historic designation. We've had four buildings designated historic. There are probably some others that should be. So we need to talk about that. And then we need to be alert to the demolition, the potential demolition of other buildings, and which ones do we want to save. This is part of the work that the committee did early on, and I'll go through this quickly. Block by block, Joanne Walsh, who's over here, a resident, Joanne, raise your hand, and also a planner, she and Max and Charlotte walked the entire corridor and did this survey block by block, and made this map, taking the Bexar County Appraisal District maps and overlaying photographs of each of the properties so you can kind of see, you know, what's there, the size of the lot, and so forth. And this goes from north to south, so I'm just going to kind of go through these quickly. You'll recognize number 10 is the building that we're in now. There's, again, number 20, the old Piggly Wiggly. The number 16 is a building that's also owned by the church. It's currently vacant and it's been vacant for a long time. And this is, you know, as we're getting further and further south. So some things of note. Capital Antiques, and I should say we'd like to thank the Los Santos family, as they were, they provided us with chairs tonight. They own Capital Antiques. Their building formerly was the Woodlawn Medical Center and then the Turner Theater. Could it possibly be considered for a historic landmark status? We have this building I brought up before, a possible brownfield site because of the uses. Whenever you've had an air conditioning company that deals with Freon, dry cleaners, those are chemicals, those can get in the dirt, and therefore they can possibly be brownfield sites. Again, that can be a challenge to a developer, but the city has some program, there are federal programs, so it's all about identifying and finding our way through the obstacles. Another possible brownfield site at 427 Fredericksburg, given the uses that were there previously. A possible historic building. This building has a lot of character to it. It was formerly the studio for Hannibal Pianta, who was known for a very unique concrete process that he did. It doesn't look like much now, but it could be restored into, I think, a wonderful, player on the boulevard. Here's another possible brownfield site. So now we're to the future. We have the Via Primo bus that unfortunately ended up traveling only from the other side of I-10 north because of the railroad crossing. They found that, you know, you can't have a bus rapid transit system when you're sitting at the railroad crossing for 20 minutes. So they now come off the freeway at Woodlawn and go north on Fred from there. But it's still within the, you know, close proximity. Martinez Creek, there will be restoration work going on there, and we have trail, dedicated hike and bike trail that's being constructed there as we speak that'll go from Wisatch and Fredericksburg down to Cincinnati, and then where the creek, the bridge is there at Cincinnati. So that's something new that's coming on board. Things that we want to consider as we think about how we want our corridor to interact with those improvements in the future. Possible historic, the NCD, which is the Neighborhood Conservation District. All these things kind of play into the what has to happen for us to revitalize the corridor. It's not just a magic wand, unfortunately. So, and then some ideas. Here are some craftsman style multifamily housing. The corridor is designated for mixed use, which means commercial or residential. And so we have the option to do both along the corridor. Here's some more intense housing. You know, the city talks about needing to provide higher density in housing as we grow. The Neighborhood Conservation District standards limit the height to 4 stories, so mid-rise. Again, here's the building that we're in now, which is mixed use with retail below and apartments above. Here's an example from Austin on Lamar, where they took an abandoned gas station and reused it, did an adaptive reuse to make it a little bicycle-friendly restaurant bar. And then there are events that could be held on the corridor. Ciclovia, no reason why we couldn't do something like that on Fredericksburg Road, just like they do on Broadway or Southtown. Some kind of market, art walks, those are all things that we could think about as a neighborhood. So here's the Midtown Neighborhoods Plan, which is a plan that was developed in 2000 in partnership between the city and the residents. And this plan is still in effect, and it was meant to be a guiding document going forward. The neighborhood said, these are the things we'd like to see, and then this plan was put into place to kind of say, here are some of our goals and things that we need to get together and get done. Unfortunately, it's a huge task, but part of what we can do now going forward is to start putting some of this into motion. And you can see economic development, revitalize and enhance the neighborhood's historic commercial corridors. Way back in 2000, people were talking about wanting to do this. They want to retain the historic character. They want to make it continue to be a pedestrian environment and not bulldoze everything down and have it just be all cars and parking lot. So these aren't new ideas that we're espousing. Multimodal transportation. Back then, they were talking about Fredericksburg as a transportation corridor. How can we make it easier and better for the businesses along here to tap into that transportation potential? The Fredericksburg Road Corridor provides via with the highest ridership within the city. Of all the city, the highest ridership is along the Fredericksburg Road Corridor, so there's a tremendous amount of public transport that happens. Bicycling, we have a bicycle advocate here from Bike Texas. We have many people here in the room that bicycle and would like to bicycle down Fredericksburg Road to work. We have some that do it already. Daniel, and others, somebody back here. Anyway, so is there something we can do there to improve that? Traffic safety, et cetera. All of these are things that are part of an existing plan. We do not need to reinvent the wheel. And then there's the Neighborhood Conservation District and their design standards. So there are several areas that this targets and controls. With density, we have no applicable design standards. So really there's no regulatory, you know, control there.
with lot size, or I'm sorry, setbacks, this is important. Buildings shall maintain a front setback between, basically not to exceed 25 feet. So what that means is you cannot develop on that corner at Woodlawn Fred a shopping center where you have all this parking in front and the buildings in the back. It's not allowed per our design standards. Okay, the buildings need to be to the front. We're looking for walkable corridor. We're looking to have the shops up front. We want people to see them as they go by. We want it to be a friendly pedestrian environment. So that's, but developers are not so crazy about that. Building height, I think it's 4 feet, four stories that we can go up. So it seems like a lot now, we don't have any of that, but we need the density. So can we provide some of that housing density on our corridor? Do we want to? What, do we want to see some housing along the corridor? Elevations and features. So it talks about doors and windows and so forth. One of the things that's important is, for example, in this space, you cannot, the owner, Mr. Maxwell, could not cover up these windows. It is not allowed. What are existing windows and the sizes need to be maintained? That's to continue to allow that interaction between the people on the street and the stores. It's also better for security. Police will tell you if they can see inside your store, they can do a better job of knowing if there's a problem. So these are all some of the design standards. So somebody wanting to come in here and remodel or build something new has to comply to both Midtown Plan and the design standards unless they try to get their zoning changed or something else. And that's, you know, what we need to be prepared for. This is a zoning map. As you can see, the corridor is sort of this zigzag of commercial, industrial lots right along the corridor, and then all to the side of that is residential. So it means we have an issue with being careful about commercial encroachment. We want revitalization, but we don't want the people living on these side streets on Craig and Russell, they don't want one by one the houses being taken away and replaced with stores. So we need to be conscientious of that, but we need to be actively involved if we're going to do that. We need to let the city know we want revitalization, we want investment, but not at the expense of our residents and commercial encroachment. Here again is the Midtown Plan. It shows you Fredericksburg Road as being designated as a mixed-use corridor. The node, the big circle, is a transit-oriented development node. And then the other red that goes horizontal along Woodlawn and in that little triangle area there to the right, that's a medium-density housing, and the yellow is all low-density. So this is what was decided in 2000. So we do have the basics, the foundation to do mixed use and transportation oriented development. And I'm done, and now it's your turn, and we need to hear from you about what you all think we should do on the corridor. And before Charlotte gets up and starts with taking your input, she's gonna write it all down. Everybody is free to speak, and hopefully people will participate. I'm going to give Charlotte Ann from Nowcast a moment to tell you a little bit about her organization and why it's important.
Like to think of ourselves as sort of like public television on the internet, except
What Nelcast does is we have documented through webcasts an enormous part of the civic activity in San Antonio. We documented every minute of SA 2020. You can find it all on our website. And I think I've seen a lot of people in this room who've seen us that have all sorts of civic events, cultural events. We do also monetize data. So the popular content on our website is our early voting maps. It lets you use your phone and look up early voting in San Antonio, and it comes up with our map, and it tells you the closest place to go early vote, and you don't get an app. And it was used by 10,000 different people in October. And 10,000 different people since October, because we kept updating that summer for every race that kept on going, and it was updated again as of June 1st, which has been really, really inspiring for the mayor's race. I'm familiar with this place, probably because Josina has been a long time supporter, but also because one of our young videographers who came to pick it up back in the beginning lived in Beacon Hill and came up with escaping with brilliant ideas, like taking videos of Diana Kersey and her Ola, the ancient irrigation ways in the community garden. And I'm thrilled to tell you that that video is one of the most popular of 800 plus videos we have on YouTube. It's been seen all over the world. Diana told me the other day she got an email from someone in Spain saying, what kind of play should I use to make that? So the impact of this hyper-local thing, what you guys did, you know, in this neighborhood, is blowing as people try to come up with better ways to use water and save water. We live in the San Antonio Library, on the sixth floor of the San Antonio Library, because the director of the San Antonio Library thinks that we are in the same business of empowering people with information. And the library has the rent, our rent. We do video things at the library, which is why among our videos we also have a playlist of five different videos of Poets Laureate in San Antonio. No other city's got one of those. We get our support in the same manner that Texas Public Radio and ALA gets their support. It's grants, donations, sponsorships, and the writing. We cooperate with Texas Public Radio. As a matter of fact, when first, we'll be live streaming the source live from Texas Public Radio. We did, as you'll see on the back of the flyer that I handed out, we have a ton of election resources, including the package we did in partnership with Texas Public Radio, long form interviews with all the candidates. And I encourage you to go check out the long form interviews with Mike Taylor and Lizzie Spanley. They're really informative when people get the chance to just speak at length about stuff. So, what's in it for you? You get to be two places at once. And you get to take credit for the fact that, you know, your little community garden is helping somebody all the way around the world be better steward of this.
Oh. start with residents. How many residents do you?
How far away from Fredericksburg Road?
Oh, yes, okay. I think if you live in Biggie Mill or if you live over on the other side of Fredericksburg, or if you live back behind us a little bit or down, it's okay. If you live anywhere near, you can drive along Fredericksburg Road. Go ahead, as resident. Okay, real high. Okay, 30. All right, how many of you are business owners? You own your own business and you run it here on Fredericksburg Road.
It's church.
Oh, higher. Or if your owner's not here and you work on...
Yes.
Yeah, if you work on... And we can include churches in that and other... Any kind of organization also. Oh, yeah.
You saying if you own the church or if you're part
of... No, if you're part... Okay, but we just need one for your church. One for your church, and of course, yes. I think there's some back there. You've got four more, right? Yeah, six of them. Okay, Jen. How about owners? Owners of buildings whose shops are in town. Max got a half way. Okay, you've got some of your shops are empty. Yeah. Is that all 24? I thought we had more.
That's very good.
Okay, maybe there's only four here. How about owners of shops that are leased out? Okay. All right. That's going to give people. Oh, and we have a whole bunch of other people here. Everybody, hold up your hand if you're the representative of an elected official. And the students, okay. How many students? Yeah, six. Six students. How many elected officials representatives are there? One, two, three, four. You're doing better than empty shops. Okay, now we go back, and we want to find out. Okay, when we take these, what you like and what you don't like, we want to be able to tell people these are residents. Or they were shop owners, or they were whatever they were. But we also need to know, okay, how many of you in here own an automobile? Okay. All right. How many of you get that automobile repaired on Fredericksburg Road? We've got a radiator shop, we've got an air conditioning shop, we've got a collision shop. We have a paint and body shop. We have about four tire shops. How many of you have ever brought your car over here and had something done to it? Oh, look at this. Oh, this is amazing. I'm really amazed. Okay, now, we've got some wonderful restaurants. We've got old ones that have been here forever. And some that have been here 30 and 25 years, and we have some that are brand new, and some that have been here 5 years and doing quite well. The big stands that Cosima showed you, that's just been painted, is an art right now. How many of you, is there anybody in here who doesn't ever eat out at all? Some people. Okay, how many of you have a meal occasionally on Fredericksburg Road? Oh, look at that. Okay. Almost 40 people. There's only 45 people. Wow. Now, okay. There's a lot of service activities go on. These chairs that we have from party rentals. Solar, you get solar power. We've got architects all along the way. Anybody have any? Oh, any of you go to the dance or the exercise classes? So that's a pretty big category there. You have an architect design your house or the party rentals or anything like that. So how many of you fit in that? You go to the exercise classes or the others? Okay. Now, how many other places along the corner where we can just plain shop. Antique shops, the accessories. You can get accessories down at Claudio's and things like that. Do you stop in any of those shops to pick up little things?
The
bike shop was one I had not. Wow, that's wonderful. Okay, and now, we also have the gas and convenience store. How many of you get your gas or your beer at the convenience store? Higher, come on. Oh, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And while I was back here on meals, I didn't know where to put the Rosie's bar. Anybody drink Rosie's? Yeah, okay. I'm gonna add that to me. Okay, there we go. All right, now we're ready. Now, we're gonna put up here. Is this big enough? Can you guys kind of see what I'm writing on here? Oh, Max is gonna put these now on the wall. Okay, we're gonna call this one attractions. Okay, you're all thinking about something you really like about Fredericksburg Road. What is something that attracts you to come down here? Now remember, I don't write very fast and we're in a hurry. So, one word and really loud so I can hear the back. Okay.
Yes, okay.
CN Festival.
Uh-oh, wait a minute, I didn't hear that.
St. Anne's Festival?
The festival, St. Anne's.
Festival.
Oh, yes, okay. Church festival. I think they have more than that.
On and off Fredericksburg Road.
Oh,
yeah.
Excuse me for repeating this, this is how I repeat it.
The pet care grooming place? What?
Pet care grooming.
Pet care grooming place?
Well, that's still there. Now, we do, here you go. All right, now, I want you to read this, the map you've got up. And I want you to read this, and I want you to tell me, what is there on these lists that we absolutely do not ever want to go away? I'm going to put a star by the one that really, if they took everything away, if the rust went away, if they took out the pet stop, whatever, what historic buildings, work, air salon, sidewalks, what do you want not to go away? Restaurants. Their food. Oh, What?
No cycling.
Unsafe device of law.
Oh.
Transients. I love my neighbor's face around the ground.
No bike lanes.
Yeah, no issue.
Yeah, this has to go real wide because I'm hearing a lot of things. But that, well, we might have to write. Are any of those real good at the top, lack of parking graffiti, lack of litter stores, and straight up's going to be your top? So more distractions, we had one.
There was something else.
Transients.
Oh, yeah, transients. I can write down.
Did you get empty buildings or?
Yeah, I did. Yeah. Okay, any more, just not so worried.
High speed traffic.
Too many lanes of traffic.
Speeding in.
Four lanes.
Too many.
It's hard to speed with all the potholes on it.
You get a speed race.
Stop.
Lack of pedestrian crossings. Oh, yes.
Bike lanes.
Lack of pedestrian crossings.
Traffic lights aren't synchronized.
Oh.
Inefficient.
Okay, and rebuilding comes up as the first priority.
I think we're
don't think that's.
Yeah.
I'm gonna ask questions.
Okay, sorry.
Oh, that's right. No, I'm sorry, I was gonna do it. Okay. The next wave.
And Tom, this is two.
Well, I just want to. Here we go. Okay. All right, our next topic is enhancement. What do we not have that you would like to see added? Okay, it sounds like I think there are quite a few things in close numbers. Thank you. You want better infrastructure, do you want more buildings, do you want less buildings, do you want more empty lots, more parks? Well, we forgot to mention we have some that were flooded.
Protected bike lanes that connect to Martinez Creek and Flores.
Okay, I'm just going to. Yeah, and the park there, that's the next one.
Can we say protected and connected?
Dedicated or protected bike lanes.
Yeah, protected and not connected to things, yeah. Okay. Enhancements, things that you want to see more of. You want to see on the corner of Fredericksburg, you want to see a 20 rise apartment building.
Are preference for local businesses,
maybe it doesn't have to be on that bridge. Maybe it could be on one of those bridges.
I think there's a combination of free space, landscaping, parking, very power lines. They combine all of those instead of being a piece of it, which is often what happens, and really disrupted for. But you can, once you do that, you make it more appealing for all of the, a lot of the things.
And now we're talking about
infrastructure.
Infrastructure, and that was really hard.
Environmental defense spot.
there's some that might not be supportive, but you might need to go for them for changes, like UP or TxDOT. Those
okay.
Ones.
Yeah, that's true.
The City Department of Planning and Community Development has money for facade improvements for businesses.
Okay. I'm just going to call that the Planning Department, and yeah, yours is now mine.
Very well. You know, we had some nice support from our congressmen over the.
started out saying between the creeks.
They're not above. They're north, yeah. But they're not going uphill.
when you get, when you sit on Woodlawn and look downtown, you see downtown. You see the tower, you see the big, I just, in fact, all the way up on his side, you see it again. And then when you get up there to 9 Mile Hill, you see it again.
Okay.
all y'all for coming. Appreciate it. Thanks very much.
Stand there, because this is who I am and this is who I am. And then maybe tilt the to the Minshew or a theater similar to Uptown Theater or Woodlawn Theater. So it's kind of more for performing arts and sedentary. And then on this corner, emphasize more the lightness, that and active area, which could be a community gym or a community meeting house. Kind of a place where people can congregate in this more open space areas. And then the space in between is walkable and shaded by a roof that kind of, by shading devices, and then a roof that covers the sidewalk where you can have vegetation and vines growing on the screen up towards the roof. And then on this side, we'll have the apartment, mixed-use dwellings, kind of residential, and then the side is more of a lived work. On this side is more of a live work complex that responds more to the neighborhood, so it's a little bit less daunting, more of a two-story house.
Okay.
We can't keep them out.
Maybe. try this.
On this side, the crack, I'm introducing a few houses, so the feeling